sweet baby stink, I mean ink. They strike once again, folks, like clockwork. Another franchise takes a nosedive the moment their name pops up in the credits. Now, I'm not saying that Sweet Baby Inc. is 100%, maybe 50% to blame, but it's kind of funny how every time a game flops, they're there, just lurking in the shadows like some sort of narrative Grim Reaper. So, let's talk about God of War Ragnarok on PC. A 5-year-old game that's finally hitting the computer, the PC, the personal computer, the gaming computers. It launched on Steam and surprise, surprise, it's pulling in half, actually less than half, of the original God of War. Yeah. 50%+ less. Sweet Baby Inc. had a hand in the story and character design, because of course they did. They even brag about their focus on representation on their website, but sure, that's totally not the reason the game's bombing, right? It's probably just those pesky technical issues, which there are many. Because forcing players to log into PlayStation Network to play a single-player game, that's just gotta be where every gamer dreams of, right? Every one of us wants to have to make a PlayStation account if you don't already have one, and we certainly trust the fact that PlayStation has a wonderful track record of being hacked multiple times, but, you know, yeah. Meanwhile, though, back at Sweet Baby Inc.'s headquarters, they're busy consulting on how to shove more DEI into games, whether it makes sense or not. Why stick to God of War's gritty Norse mythology when you can tick off a diversity checklist instead? Who needs immersion? And you've got a quota-filled character clogging up the narrative. And if you're wondering why gamers are throwing up their hands and walking away, maybe, just maybe, it's because nobody actually asked for this. But Sweet Baby Inc. keeps doubling down, assuring us they're just misunderstood and oh so innocent. Yeah. Sure, totally innocent, like P. Diddy levels of innocent. That's why they've got a growing track record of tanking games, while players are running for the hills, swearing off anything Sweet Baby breathes on, let alone touches. And then there's the cherry on top of the shit sundae. Sony forcing a PlayStation Network sign-in for a single-player game. Because clearly, what gamers really, 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 really want is to hand over more personal data to a company that infamously gets hacked. I would say that was a great, brilliant, and wonderful move by Sony, wouldn't you? So now, we're left with Ragnarok limping along with its pathetic 35,000-ish player peak, half, less than half, of the original game. And, well, behind Ghosts of Tsushima. But hey, maybe being forced to log into your PlayStation Network sign-in, if you have one, or make one if you don't, diversity-driven story changes and broken technical issues had nothing to do with that. That's entirely believable. Look, folks, the writing's on the wall. Sweet Baby Inc. is just bad news for games, and gamers aren't dumb. We, they, us, are fed up with intrusive logins, buggy launches, and shoehorned agendas. But will Sony listen? Will any of them actually listen? The big companies, I mean? Unfortunately, probably not. Not for a very long time. After all, why take feedback from the people who actually play your games? Because that sounds just way too logical to listen to the customer now, doesn't it? Anyway, those are just my thoughts on the newest launch for God of War Ragnarok's PC debut. And for more opinion-based videos from a cartoon guy on the internet, do me the giant favor of liking, subscribing, sharing, and commenting below. And I will see you, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, later on. Have yourselves, as always, a great, wonderful, and prosperous day. Bye-bye.